Hello, Klaus here with another DaVinci Resolve iPad tutorial, and it's just a super quick one. It's just, did you know that we have kind of two inspectors in the cut page in the iPad version? Of course, we have the regular inspector over here where we can change stuff around, but we actually have more or less the same functions if we click on this icon right here. We're going to get this new menu up here, and we can do some different things in here. For instance, if I take this one, I can go in and I can change my image, zoom in my image, rotating it up or down, changing everything around the position and stuff like that, turning it around if I want to. And if I want to reset any of my values, I can just go right here to this icon and push, and it'll go back to the starting point. Then I also have a crop where I can crop my image if I want to. For some reasons, I want to do a crop in this. I can change that, and I can do that the same way as in the inspector or as right here. Again, I'm just going to say this is good for now. I can also feather my borders out here like that if I want to. So, and then, of course, I can reset everything right here again. Then we have this is the zoom function. And so let's say I want to do a zoom into this image. And by default, if I put the green box here, it should be my endpoint. So if I start here, it will go from being very close, and then it's going to zoom from the green box to the red box. So we can easily change stuff around if we don't want the zoom to be too crazy. So if we go here, we can see it's going to do a slow zoom out, and again we can redo everything we did again just by clicking right here. And if we want to take off the effect, we can just click right here. It's just going to take that right off. So if we go to this one, I mean, this is more something you would use if you had two clips. So we can take this teddy bear clip here and put that on top. So I'm going to select that clip, and then I can actually change the composite mode, for instance, to darken, or I could put it in like a color, stuff like that. So this is how I could, you know, add in different effects or combine images together. And of course, I have a opacity slider right here. So now I have done something strange, and nice to know it's there. And you can then, of course, redo whatever we did here, and I'm just going to throw away that clip. And then we have here speed change if we want to make our clips slower and stuff like that. And if we go here, we have our stabilizer. Here we can change the different modes and just hit stabilize. This is a tripod shot, so that's no point in doing that. And if we go here, we can go in and we can analyze our lens and distortion and stuff like that, but there's no need to do that. We also have a color. And in fact, we can, if we select the clip here, we can auto-color just from this tab here, just by clicking. And of course, this is a great starting point, and then we could go in and continue further in the color page. And last one we have, of course, is audio, and here we can control the audio volume up and down, but you don't really have too much control with the audio. You have a little more if you go in to the inspector, and we can control the audio stuff like that. But still, you don't have so much control of audio in the iPad version unless you do the trick where you show all of the pages, and you can of course go into Fairlight and try to see if that's working out for you as well. So this was just a little video about the two different inspectors inside of the DaVinci Resolve iPad version. I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.